beautiful moments for everyone that we are gathered here just for one purpose, that how we could bring peace in our society, in our countries, in our communities, and in our family. As Honorable Brother Gesena has mentioned very clearly, this organization is working according to the will of God. And will of God is that how we could be unified just for one purpose, and how we could bring peace to this society, celebrating our love for families and for our communities as well. So this is, I think, a very unique conference today, as Sister Dugan, in her opening address, she has mentioned that we will be exploring few subjects, and the subjects are basically related to everyone. These are not those kind of subjects that we are not discussing, even at our breakfast table, at our, you know, before concluding our day and our night prayer, we think about all these things, you know. We think about that how we could bring our family united. We think about that how we could have a peace. We think about that how we could be good human beings. So this is the purpose of this conference. I believe that we should unitedly, you know, congratulate to the Universal Peace Federation. Universal Peace Federation, actually the founder of this organization, Reverend Dr. Sun Yung Moon, because he was the person that he wanted to see everyone happy, everyone, you know, high-spirited according to their own belief. He wanted to see everyone that they should have some moral values with them. So this was the purpose of this organization. And peace, I think that the peace, if we have a peace in our family, then we have peace in our society. If we have peace in our society, then we could see peace around the globe. So these are the fundamentals to the peace. Brothers and sisters, I'm really very thankful that Universal Peace Federation has, you know, provided human and spiritual and all kind of resources to those people who they had no resources. And what kind of resources? That resource of love. It's a big resource, I believe, that how we could change the politics, how we could have a good governance, how we could have a good system of marriage. You know, these are the things which they have provided. My heart goes to the organizers, including my organization as well, that the Common Grounds. The Common Grounds, you'll be very happy to learn about this one, that in past 15 years, with the help of the Universal Peace Federation, we had generated interfaith dialogue in that country where they had no concept of interfaith dialogue. I mean that Saudi Arabia, I was meeting with the Imam of Kaaba in 2007. Then I had a meeting in 2015. Then again I had a meeting in 2017. And the purpose was that we should focus the interfaith dialogue in the kingdom. And fortunately, at that time, because of my, you know, humble service, they initiated two conferences in the kingdom. And these were the two, you know, first ever in the history of kingdom, they initiated two conferences for the interfaith. So this is what we have done with the help of the Universal Peace Federation. And then I started one, you know, another project that was Vatican to Mecca. My wife and me were, you know, part of Pope's audience meeting. And then we were meeting with the Imam of Kaaba. It was really very meaningful. Meaningful in that perspective, that how Universal Peace Federation is helping those organizations who they are working closely with them. And I'm really thankful to Sister Tomeko Dugan, because every moment she remembers us in her love, you know, and she's working so hard. We have to give strength to her, power to her, more power to her, because she is the one in this area that she's working very hard. Another thing which I want to mention to you, that as Brother Desana has mentioned about 2000 conference and right after 9/11, you know, 2001 conference in New York, it was a time I had seen horror and terror in New York, and people were silent. No one was speaking out. Only the Universal Peace Federation, they came out, and with the blessings of the Reverend Dr. Sun Myung Moon, they invited 500 people in New York. And I had seen, I witnessed, because I was part of that conference, and thanks to Dr. Mali Halodi, because she was also working with that at the time, you know, with the because we tried to bring many people from Pakistan, because about Pakistan, people were thinking, maybe, actually it was not. So this conference was helping to the people to bring peace in New York, and it was a landmark in the history of the America, I think so. So this was very important event in New York. I brought almost 19 people to the conference. They were the leadership of Muslim world, and it made a great, you know, event at that time. So one thing which I want to mention here, that with the help of the Universal Peace Federation, the Common Ground, in 2003, we invited Muslims, Qaris, you know, reciters of the Holy Quran from 7 countries, and they were the beautiful Qaris. I know that most of the people know about Qari Basim. His son was part of that Qari group, you know, and they were from Iran, from Indonesia, from Turkey, and they were reciting Quran. And who was providing help to them? Universal Peace Federation. So these are the accomplishments of Universal Peace Federation in every nation. I have mentioned you just about Pakistan. I know about other nations as well, because I have witnessed the history, and history is making us proud. Thank you very much, Universal Peace Federation and the other organizations. And I really thankful to my colleagues in the Common Ground, who they are working very hard for peace perspectives. And I welcome to the distinguished participants of this conference, who they will be exploring different themes in the perspective of peace. God bless you.